Welcome, my dear learners, for this course on mechanical vibrations. In this module 1, we were discussing on free undamped vibration systems and free damped vibration. So far, we have solved 6 problems on how to determine natural frequency for an free undamped vibrating systems. Let us continue our discussion, the problem number 7 and 8 on our discussion on undamped free vibration states that determine the natural frequency of the system shown in figure if the mass of the rod is neglected compared to the mass m. We want to determine the natural frequency for problem number 7 and 8, wherein which we have for a pendulum the springs are attached. Let us move on and solve this problem 7 and 8 quickly. So if I move for problem number 7, so problems on simple pendulum can be solved by equating the moment about a point to 0. What I mean to say is that you take moment about pivot points and equate them to 0, you will get the solution for the problem. So this is how we should solve for simple pendulums. So for equilibrium, that is sum of moments about pivot points O must be equal to 0. This is the condition for equilibrium. Now we have to take moments, I want to know the forces, various forces acting, for which I should draw free body diagram. If I draw free body diagram, I can know what are the forces acting and their direction. Free body diagram is the pictorial representation of forces and their directions. So if I draw the free body diagram for the given problem, the forces acting, the various forces acting will be like this. So we have an axis, and we have the pendulum. Now we have the mass m here, so therefore force due to gravity will be mg acting downward. Since it is deflected towards right, the restoring forces should act towards left. The system is disturbed towards right side, so therefore restoring forces should act towards left side. So therefore the direction of restoring forces will be like this. So first restoring force is inertia force, that is mass times the acceleration, inertia, mass times the acceleration, inertia force and gravitational force we have marked. Coming for spring forces, so here I have one spring force. If stiffness is K, then what is force? Stiffness is defined as force per deflection, therefore force is equal to stiffness into deflection. So how much is the deflection? If this length is B, then this length will be B sin theta. So therefore the force will be KB sin theta. KB sin theta is the force, and the distance to this force will be, if this distance is B, then the vertical distance will become B cos theta. So similarly, we have one more force here which should act towards left because the disturbance is towards right. So this force will be how much? This force will be K A sin theta, K A sin theta, because hypotenuse is A, K A sin theta is the force acting, and the distance from pivot point O will be A cos theta, will be A cos theta. Whereas for these two forces, how much is this distance? So this distance is how much? This is L, so therefore it is L sin theta is the distance for gravitational force. Whereas for inertia force, if I measure the distance will be, this distance will be how much? For the inertia force, so this length is L, so this length will become L cos theta. You are correct, it is L cos theta. it is L cos theta. Now, as I said, for equilibrium, the moment about pivot point must be equal to 0. I have drawn the free body diagram with the forces and their directions. Since the disturbance is towards right, the restoring forces should act towards left. Now, taking moment about point O, we start with inertia force. Therefore, the inertia force is mx double dot into the perpendicular distance is L cos theta plus mg. So if you observe, I am taking moment about point O, inertia force is causing clockwise moment. Inertia force is causing clockwise moment. The force due to gravity is also causing clockwise moment. So therefore plus mg is the force into distance is L sin theta, and spring forces are also causing clockwise moments. So they should also be get added plus kb sin theta, kb sin theta into b cos theta is the distance into b cos theta plus ka sin theta into a sin theta must be equal to 0. Inertia force, force due to gravity and spring forces, sum of the moments taken about point O, all are causing clockwise moment, must be equal to 0. Now the careful observation will reveals that what is the value of x? X is this. What is the value of x? X is this length. So for small deflections I can use s is equal to r theta formula. So therefore x can be written as L theta. So x can be written as L theta. Therefore x double dot can be written as L theta double dot for small deflections. Use the formula s is equal to r theta. So therefore this deflection here can be written as s is equal to r theta, hence it is L theta. Hence x double dot will become L theta double dot. Make substitutions here. Before that we use the condition for small deflections, for small values of theta. What is the value of sin theta for small values of theta? For small values of theta, sin theta is nearly equal to theta and cos theta is nearly equal to unity, 1. So make substitutions and solve. If I make substitution, x double dot is L theta double dot, hence it is m L theta double dot into L into 1, cos theta is 1 into L will become L square. So m L square theta double dot plus m g L, sin theta is nearly equal to theta, hence I should write it as m g L theta plus kb theta into b into 1, it will become kb square theta. This will become ka square theta is equal to 0. Now in order to obtain the standard form, the coefficient of acceleration term should be unity. So therefore divide this equation throughout by m l square. If I divide this equation throughout by m l square, I left out with theta double dot plus mgl plus k times a square plus b square, a square plus b square whole divided by ml square into theta is equal to 0. So we obtained the standard form, that is theta double dot plus omega n square x is equal to 0. Hence, this is equal to omega n square. Hence, the value of natural frequency fn, which is equal to omega n by 2 pi, will be equal to what? 1 by 2 pi. So, this is the value of omega n square. Hence, omega n will be how much? Root of that value. So, root of that value is square root of this value. So, if I write it separately, it is g by l plus times a square plus b square divided by ml square. ML square hertz. This is the solution. A careful observation will reveal that if I remove spring, you remove these two springs, then it will become just a simple pendulum. What is the formula for natural frequency of a simple pendulum? The natural frequency of a simple pendulum is given by square root of g by l radians per second. That is what I will get. Remove spring, put k is equal to 0, this will vanish. What I will get? Root of g by l. It is 1 by 2 pi root of g by l hertz. That is the natural frequency of simple pendulum. Since we have springs, this term is the additional part for simple pendulum. Hence the solution is correct. So this is how we should solve whenever we have problems on pendulum. Just take moment about a pivot point and equate it to 0. For that you should know how to draw free body diagram. If you draw free body diagram, you will come to know the direction of forces and the distance from pivot point. Take moment, equate it to 0 and simplify, you will get the answer. Let us move on for problem number 8. If we move for solution of problem number 8, we have again for this problem also, take sum of moments, sum of moment about pivot point O must be equal to 0. This is the condition for equilibrium. Now if I draw the free body diagram for this, if I draw free body diagram for this given problem, what I will get? We have a fixed axis like this. Let me deflect the mass. Let me deflect the mass towards left side. If I deflect the mass towards left side, let me draw the axis also for reference. Let me deflect the mass like this. So here we'll have the force due to acceleration due to gravity, that is mg. Since it is disturbed towards left, the restoring force should act towards right, correct? So here the force should act towards right, that is inertia force. What is the value of inertia force? Mx double dot should act towards right, because disturbance is towards left, restoring force should act towards right. And this angle is known, that is theta. And if you carefully observe, these two springs are in parallel case because one end of these two springs are fixed. So therefore K1 and K2 are parallel. Very good. K1 and K2 are parallel. So therefore the equivalent stiffness is nothing but K1 plus K2. The equivalent stiffness is nothing but K1 plus K2. Since the inverted pendulum is deflected towards left, the restoring force should act towards right. Hence the restoring force due to the springs which are in parallel case will be K1 plus K2 is the spring stiffness, equivalent stiffness into deflection. Deflection is how much? Deflection is a theta. Distance is a, deflection is theta. Hence the linear deflection will become a theta. It is a theta is the force. K1 plus K2 a theta. K1 plus K2 a theta. Now what is the perpendicular distances of these forces acting? What is the perpendicular distance of these forces acting? So this distance is easier to know. He himself has been specified. This distance is given for us. This distance is a. This is the pivot point O. And the distance for inertia force is also given. It is a plus b. This distance is also specified. This distance is a plus b. And how much is this distance? This distance is nothing but s is equal to r theta. That is, the overall length is a plus b into theta. So this distance will become a plus b into theta. So from the figure, what I can write the deflection x as x is equal to a plus b into theta. Hence, x double dot must be equal to a plus b theta double dot. So this is the x what I am considering. This distance, how much is the disturbance is x. X is equal to a plus b theta. Now take moment about point O. First inertia force, if I take inertia force is causing clockwise moment. Hence it is force into distance. Distance is a plus b. Vertical distance is a plus b. Now coming for force due to gravity. If I observe force due to gravity from point O, force due to gravity is causing counterclockwise moment. Hence it should be minus mg, counterclockwise moment. Mg is the force into distance is x. X is a plus b theta. A plus b theta. Now coming for equivalent stiffness of the combined effect of these two springs, that is also causing clockwise moment. Hence it is positive plus k1 plus k2. A theta is the force into distance is how much? A. This must be equal to 0. So we have inertia force, force due to gravity and spring force. The moments must be equal to 0. Clockwise moments are taken positive, counterclockwise moments are taken as negative. Now if I simplify further, substituting the value of x double dot, it is a plus b theta double dot. I end up with m of a plus b whole square theta double dot plus k1 plus k2 a square minus mg of a plus b into theta is equal to 0 is the simplification. And then I have done just the simplification. Correct. Now in order to obtain the standard form, the coefficient of acceleration term should be unity. So therefore divide this equation throughout by m a plus b whole square. So if I do that, I'll end up with theta double dot plus k1 plus k2 a square minus mg of a plus b whole divided by m of a plus b whole square into theta is equal to 0. So this term is nothing but omega n square. This is of the form theta double dot plus omega n square theta is equal to 0. Hence this is omega n square. So therefore natural frequency fn, which is equal to omega n by 2 pi, will be equal to how much? 1 by 2 pi square root of 1 by 2 pi square root of this term, that is k1 plus k2 into a square divided by m of a plus b whole square minus mg by, sorry, mm will get cancelled, right, g by a plus b, g by a plus b hertz. So this is the natural frequency for the given system in figure 8. So this system will not vibrate if natural frequency is equal to 0. If natural frequency is equal to 0, the system will not vibrate. So you can also ask the problem such a way that determine the value of B if the natural frequency of the system is equal to 0. Then I can find the value of B in terms of A, K1, K2 and M. That is, equate omega n is equal to 0, you'll get the expression for B. So if I extend this problem to find the value of B if the system is not vibrating. So if natural frequency is 0, then system will not vibrate. For such cases, equate omega n is equal to 0 and solve. If I do that, what I'll get will be the value of B. K1 plus K2 into A square minus MGA whole divided by MG. This is what, if B equal to the value K1 plus K2 into A square minus MGA by MG, then the system will not vibrate. So you can also expect the question like this. Find the value of B for which the system will not vibrate. The system will not vibrate for B is equal to this value. How I obtained this one? Equate this term to 0. Equate this term to 0 and simplify, you will get the value of B in terms of the other parameters. So this is how you should solve whenever you encounter problems on pendulum with springs. It is just take moment about pivot point and equate it to 0. And to do that, you should know how to draw free body diagram. Free body diagram will give us the forces and their directions. The direction of forces is always opposite to the disturbance. That's all from this lecture. Thank you all.